Mesozoic Asia was a land of monsters. The rich fossil beds of Mongolia have revealed hulked-out ducks like Deinochirus, gangly clawed creatures like Therizinosaurus, and sleek, elephant-sized carnivores like Tarbosaurus. Further south, China has given us gigantic sauropods like Mamenchisaurus and Zhuchengtyrannus, the intimidating hadrosaur Shantungosaurus, and Zhuchengtyrannus, a tyrannosaur that ranged from average African bush elephant size to twice that. But Russia, in the frigid north, is not to be left out of the contest. As it turns out, the land of political conflict, snow, and stereotypical Hollywood villains once was home to a megatyrannosaur of its own, one that may have rivaled the biggest land predators of all time.
I must break you.
Our story begins in 1949, when schoolboy Igor Maastrichtian discovered an outcrop of fossils in Blagoveshchensk. Excavation of the area began later that year, and along with study of the Kundur locality in the 80s, revealed that the Udurchukan formation had an ecosystem similar to that of Hell Creek from late Maastrichtian North America. It was a subtropical environment, with large rivers, dominated by ferns and conifers. It was crawling with lambiosaurine hadrosaurs, including a murosaurus, which was discovered in a bone bed in 2008. It's known from material from multiple individuals and was about the size of a large rhinoceros at 8 meters long and 3 tons, with some specimens reaching 11 meters and nearly 8 tons. Saurolophines were common as well, including Kerberosaurus, similar in size, and Condurosaurus, slightly smaller at 7 meters and 2 tons. Aloratitan, another lambiosaurine hadrosaur, is in the 8-ish meter and 2.5 to 3.5 ton range. Unlike Hell Creek, the Udurchukan formation has a resident sauropod. It's known from poor material, a single caudal vertebra, and is regarded as a Sumpfospondylan sauropod, making it ambiguously related to macronarians like Brachiosaurus and Titanosaurs. Dubiously known as Archaravia, it was in the 5 to 7 ton range and may have been about 11 to 12 meters long. More indeterminate remains of dinosaurs are known from Udurchukan: nodosaurids, dromaeosaurs, ornithomimids, and troodontids. And, of course, the apex predator that you clicked on the video for. Multiple fragmentary tyrannosaurine specimens are known from the two localities, Kartur and Blagoveshchensk, both part of the Udurchukan formation. The specimens range in size from about Nanotyrannus letheus, or about 3 times the size of a grizzly bear, to comparable to full-grown Tyrannosaurus rex. A pedal phalanx, or toe bone, with a catalog number ANHM1-1098 is the smallest specimen. It's about half the length as the equivalent bone in the T-Rex Sioux, indicating a 6.3-meter, 1,300-kilogram animal. Whether this represents a juvenile of a bigger animal or the adult of a Nanotyrannus analog is unknown. There are also two fairly complete caudal vertebrae, identified by the authors of a 2021 paper as a caudal 19 or 20 and 24 or 25 respectively. They're similar in morphology to Tyrannosaurus rex, but are notably smaller, 76 to 78% the size of the same elements in Sioux. That would result in this individual being comparable in size to Tarbosaurus, at close to 10 meters long and 4.8 to 5 tons. While impressive, that's just towing the line of megatheropod status. Quite a few tyrannosaurid teeth have been found from the area, of varying sizes. Tooth scaling in reptiles is an iffy practice, since reptiles typically have teeth that vary in size significantly, even within individuals. Most of the tyrannosaur teeth from Udurchukan are comparable in size to those from Despletosaurus, but the largest of them has a dental crown that measures 13 centimeters tall. That's comparable to teeth from big rex specimens like Stan, 15 cm largest tooth crown, and Sue, 12 cm largest tooth crown. The sheer variability involved in teeth makes a specific size impossible to calculate, but as a range, we're likely looking at an animal between 7 and 10 tons and 11 to 12 meters long. Another scrappy remnant indicates a second rex-sized specimen. It's a first metacarpal, or wrist bone, about 10% longer and slightly wider than the corresponding bone in Sue. And before you go crazy in the comments, no, I'm not saying that this Russian Tyrannosaur is bigger than Sue, bigger than Rex, yada yada yada. These remains are quite fragmentary, and both teeth and metacarpals have a wide range of individual variation. Don't go throwing crazy numbers out there. But on the other end, it's unfounded to suggest that this animal, which we'll call Reznyadrakon, Russian for Carnage Dragon, is significantly smaller than T-Rex, given how similar in morphology and size the big specimens are. scaling from Tarbosaurus might yield different numbers, but overlapping material in complete specimens is lacking. Again, 7 or 8 to 10 tons is a reasonable range, depending on what taxon you scale from. With the uncertainty and fragmentary nature of these remains taken into account, we see quite a size range across the various Reznyadrakon specimens from Udurchukan. The bigger individuals almost certainly represent some of the largest megatheropods ever found, although you couldn't pull precise numbers out of me. I wouldn't consider it responsible to give an estimate for the metacarpal owner any higher than 10 tons, given how much arm and hand bones can vary between individuals, but it's still certainly a roughly T-Rex-sized animal, along with the owner of the 13-centimeter tooth. That means Russia's apex predator is about the same size as the infamous giant Zhuchengtyrannus magnus, which with fragmentary specimens is comparable to big Rexes. Heck, Reznyadrakon is likely a close relative of Zhuchengtyrannus, given how the 2021 paper mentions that extremely similar teeth were found in northern China. It's important to recognize that we don't know the maturity of any of these specimens, so we don't know if the fragments we have represent a growth series or multiple tyrannosaurine taxa of different sizes. In theory, we could be looking at a trio of 1 plus ton, 4 to 5 ton, and 8 to 10 ton species in the same environment, with dromaeosaurs and troodontids filling the small predator niches. Or they belong to the same tyrannosaurid, the Carnage Dragon that ruled Russia from a young age. And remember, because I know there will be people who only look at the headline and ignore the disclaimers and context, I'm not saying that Reznyadrakon is bigger than Sue or even necessarily the same size as Sue. Teeth and wrist bones are not weight-bearing bones and are not great for scaling. The only thing we can confidently say is that Russia had a T-Rex-sized tyrannosaur that lived at the same time as T-Rex, hunting hadrosaurs and sauropods. I wonder if there were also huge herbivores that we haven't uncovered from the Udurchukan formation, given how even the biggest so far, the indeterminate sauropod, is still likely smaller than the biggest tyrannosaurid specimens from the area. As funny as the image of a supergiant carnivore eating hadrosaurids a third its size is, I'd expect that more material would reveal an X-Rex or Shantungosaurus-sized ornithopod. Perhaps a ceratopsian as well, although the really big ones seem restricted to North America so far. Oh yeah, and that 13-centimeter tooth crown? That's already a respectable size for a Rex. But a recently unearthed Rex specimen currently undergoing excavation by Clayton Phipps just broke the world record for longest T-Rex tooth. Twice, within the same maxilla. There's currently very little information on this animal, but the dig will resume next year. We can expect updates in the future, and you'll know where to find them. On a similar note, what with the Giganotosaurus scans, giant Zhuchengtyrannus, giant Meraxes, dragon of Cedar Mountain, and now Reznyadrakon, it will soon be time to make an updated megatheropod compilation. If only we'd finally get a published mega abelisaurid. I wish Titanovenator would finally jump out of the rumor mill and make a public appearance. If there are any other new megatheropods from 2025, let me know so I can add them to the 2026 edition of the tier list. I've been making annual or biannual updates for a while, and I get a huge kick out of it, mainly because it shows us how quickly paleontology is changing. It's a good time to be a dinosaur nerd. Thanks for watching! If you'd like to learn more about the Dragon of Cedar Mountain, a 4 to 5 ton carcharodontosaurid that lived with Utah Raptor, you can check out my recent video on the subject. And if you haven't already, please consider donating to Dinos vs. Cancer, the immunotherapy fundraiser for the Cancer Research Institute organized by Creature Archives. Our goal is to reach $3,000 by December 14th, 2025, and with your help, we know we can make that happen. As of this video's recording, we're just about halfway there, with 3 weeks left to go. Feel free to join the channel as a Raptor member to gain loyalty badges and shoutouts with early access to videos at the Megatheropod tier. I'm the Vividen, and I'll see you the next time a giant tyrannosaur appears to join the war against the Megacarks.